Hi, this is Derek Rodriguez. I'm from the beautiful island of Guam. Welcome to the Millard High Mecca 80s reunion brought to you by the class of 84.
From the 80s decade, the class of 81 was so memorable. We had so much life and personality, imagination, the know-how to have fun, that they put us in a contained room when we were in seventh grade. Wouldn't let us associate with the rest of the junior high. But, you know, it's things like that that make us the favorite. We were the favorite, right?
No. Yes, I can recall.
Wouldn't you say the class of 89 is your favorite?
Yes, a lot.
If the world was a stage, where would the people sing?
Now, if all the world's a stage, where does the audience sit? Well, maybe on their butts. But then again, depends.
So, would you say the best class forevermore was the class of 84?
Yes, a lot.
Ag, do pigs pull their hamstrings?
I think the answer to Bill's question on whether pigs pull their hamstring, I'm afraid we'd have to get a congressional committee to evaluate that, but in my opinion, I think they do. At least the smarter ones do. They know what strings to pull to get ahead. And the others, they just have to struggle along in the muck and the mire. So the smart pigs do pull their hamstrings. Would that answer the question? And I don't know who gives the pigs the IQ to see who's smart and who isn't. But that would probably be my answer to this, having not gone into it in depth.
Wouldn't you say that the class of 1980 was the best class you ever taught?
Yes, a lot.
Which class was the best? Well, it was 85, right?
No.
Class of 85 is the best alive. Right?
Yes, a lot.
Mr. Jolly, when French people swear, do they say, pardon my English?
I heard you one more while I was back in the hospital. Lying awake and sent the tuning in on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming to me.
Well, first of all, I'd like to say hello to all the Millard High alumni from the 80s. That's a long time ago. But in answer to the question, I would say that the older generations of French people would probably not say that, simply because they appreciate what the Americans did during World War II. But but probably the younger generations might say that just to try to be funny. Who knows?
Hi, Coach. My question is, Why does no one ever say it's only a game when they're winning?
Well, because when you're winning, you want to make it a lot bigger than just a game. When you're losing, then you want to make people think, well, it's just...
Out of the 80s, 1987 was the best year ever.
Didn't you say the class of 86 was best?
Yes, a lot.
Hey, this is Sean Rasmussen shooting from inside BR's old classroom. And I have a question for Mr. Watson. If there's an airplane flying with 1,000 seagulls inside weighing 2 pounds each, and they're flying inside the plane, does the plane weigh 2,000 pounds more?
Well, if eagles, you put 200 eagles in a plane, eagles aren't like normal birds. They're made of gold. That's why we have we named them eagles. So they weigh more than the regular thing. So they weigh probably an extra 100 pounds than you'd think they would. So that's why you'd have more weight than normal.
Our class, the class of 1988, had several amazing experiences. Some of the teachers thought it was so great, they even graduated with it. So our class was the best class ever, right?
Yes, a lot.
Well, I want to thank Michelle for giving me the opportunity to speak about my time at Millard. One of the first questions is, do I know the Millard high school song? It's a little shaky, but I think I can recall a little bit of it. Let me see if I got it now. Dun 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 dun. It's getting near dawn. Dun 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 dun. When eagles have closed their eyes, dun dun dun, they'll soon beat all who try. Dun dun dun, to darken their bright skies. Dun dun dun, they'll fight for us through the night. Dun dun dun, they'll fight till the rabbits call for mercy. Dun dun dun. That's about all that I recall, but I remember standing and singing that song, and it touches my heart every time I do. The other, have I ever been to a bunny burn? Well, I have, in a way. I helped gather wood for the bunny burn. I remember that. I went over to the Deldale Stadium and found some wood among the bleachers and was able to haul that back over to Miller. So I was glad for what I was able to do there. And did I ever participate in stealing an outhouse for a bunny burn? Well, in a way, yes, I did. I remember the night, and I was outside using the facilities close to my house, and when people began trying to pull it off the ground, but they did allow me to get out and be on my way before they actually took it. So I was there for that. I was actually there for that. So great to be with you, and I hope you're having a wonderful time at your reunion.
Okay, so it's been a long time since we were in high school, but we may be reaching the time where we don't remember who was really the best class ever, right? So I'm just going to remind you that 1983 was the best class ever, right?
So tell me, if there's a speed of light and a speed of sound, is there also a speed of smell?
As long
There were mountains. Well, speed of smell has to do with the age of the person, not with the speed of anything else. Because when a person gets older, they don't smell as well. So at my age, I can still change the baby's diapers and it doesn't stink half so bad.
Going now. All right, we're here with Mr. Brown, and he hasn't changed any. And Mr. Brown, I sort of went over the questions with you a little bit, but have you ever been to a bunny burn?
Yes, several
of them. And in the process, were you ever involved in acquiring an outhouse?
Not here.
No, just a minute. What do you mean not here?
Not since I've been at Millard High School.
Not so before that, you were?
Well, yes.
Well, that sounds pretty interesting.
In
there.
In earlier days.
And don't worry about it, because the statute of limitations has run out on that.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. And so the other thing is we want to see if you're going to be the first one to say or sing the school song.
Oh, okay.
All right, let's hear what you can do here.
Millard High, the school of education.
I even forgot it right
now.
Anyway. What was the motto in the song? Remember that? Our motto. Too many years. Come on. we had hope. We had hope right
had
here.
Hopes, yeah.
All right.
My memory's gone. It's been too many years.
All right. Well, you did wonderful.
Well, we did something, but not wonderful.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, by the way, wasn't 1984 the best year?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
That's what I thought. Thank you.
All right. Hi, Mrs. Mehmet.
Hi.
Mrs. Mehmet actually started driving the bus when?
In 1986.
And now she's still driving the bus, yet she works at Millard High School, so we thought we'd interview her as well. Can you sing or recite the words of the school song?
No.
Uh-oh. Have you ever attended a bunny burn?
Yes, I have.
Did you ever steal an outhouse?
Yes, I have.
Let's hear the story.
No, I told a tale.
Mrs. Mehmet, come on. You don't want to share the story?
No, I don't want to share the story.
All right.
It's too embarrassing.
Thank you for...
When did you start teaching at Millard High?
I started in August of 1986.
Can you sing or recite the words of the school song?
Yes, I can, but I don't want to sing it. Millard High, the School of Education. Every year we come to join with you. Each one here is filled with new ambition to show the world what Millard High can do.
Good job.
Do you need more?
No, you're good. Have you ever attended a bunny burn?
Yes, many of them.
Okay. Did you ever steal an outhouse?
Never.
Never?
Never.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Tell me what year you started teaching.
I came to Fine Millard High School in 1987.
And what year did you graduate?
I graduated in 1981.
You should be attending this reunion. All right, we're going to ask you a couple questions. Can you sing or recite the words of the school song?
Millard High, the School of Education. Every year we come to join with you. Yes, I can.
Thank you.
And we don't clap. That was a thing started by outsiders.
Okay, second question. Have you ever attended a bunny burn?
Many. In fact, I have hauled the wood, among other things, for numerous, being the FFA advisor.
Did you ever steal an outhouse?
I have been involved in many, but I will take the Fifth Amendment on that.
All right. Thanks, Mr. Hunter.
So if a picture is worth 1,000 words, what is a picture of 1,000 words worth?
Well, that's an interesting question. I think I need Mrs. Baugh's help on this one. But I would say that it depends on who wrote the words, maybe how they're written. But if you want a dollar value, let's just say $15 million. How does that sound?
Back in high school, since you were the driver's ed person, who of all the kids that you drove with gave you the whitest knuckles?
Oh, that would be difficult to answer because several did, and I can't remember their the exact ones over this period of time.
I might have to come back and let you think on that one. Okay. Did you ever go to a bunny burn?
Yes.
Okay. Were you ever involved in stealing an outhouse?
No.
No, you weren't, huh? Okay. And also, do you remember the school song? Could you say it or sing it, however you want to do it?
Yes.
All right, let's hear you say it or sing it.
Millard High, the School of Education. Each one here is will with new ambition.
Okay. We'll never let old Millard fall?
That's right.
Something like that, huh? Okay. All right, I'm going to go ahead and... Is there anything else special you'd like to say?
Well, we wish them success and in their years ahead.
Okay. All right. Thank you for your participation here.
Ag, I have a confession to make. Leslie Hunt and I, and 18 other people, freshman year, the night before school started, we're the ones that toilet papered your house. I'm sorry.
Go.
I've got a secret. Secret. Mr. DeYoung, I'm so sorry it was me that started the rumors that you were Dennis DeYoung's brother and a ghostwriter on Mr. Roboto. I've had it stuck in my brain ever since. I hear it 24/7. I can't get it to go away. I want it to stop. So hopefully, my hot tub confession will make it go away once and forever. Again, I'm deeply sorry.
We have Coach Munson, and everyone remembers him for sure. Anyway, I asked you a minute ago if you had ever been involved in acquiring or stealing an outhouse, and your answer was what?
No, I never did myself go out and with others and steal an outhouse, but I knew that it was being done, and even when I was coaching, some of the kids, you know, some of the ball players were going out and getting one. In fact, there for years, I wondered if we were going to ever find another one. I thought we'd cleaned the town out of outhouses. But yeah, it was a big part that, and then we always had the Millard High Eagle out there, and a couple of times when I thought the football players were not quite getting as ready as they should, one particular time I went and got a couple of my ninth grade PE kids who were football players and had them paint the eagle red. Just to get our guys mad and upset and ready to go the next day. The outhouse thing and burning of that was a big part of our of our game with Bill each year.
And what about, you say you've been to a bunny burn before.
And I've been to a lot of them. In fact, I'm not sure we didn't originate that back in 1950 and 51 when I was playing. We won the first state championship Millard ever won in 1950. You know, I graduated in 51, but we had it back there, and I'm not sure that we'd never got out of the semifinals and had trouble winning the semifinal game. And that year we had that big bunny burn, and I think that was the first time it ever happened, but I'm not sure of that. But it seems like it was. And then we beat Lehigh in the semifinal game and went on and won the state championship in the fall of 1950.
Wow. All right, then I guess that's where we'll let this one off, and we sure appreciate your time there, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Anderson, I have a question for you. If you write a book about failure and it doesn't sell, is it called success?
Welcome, friends and alumni of Millard High School. What a pleasure it is for me to be able to talk to you here in my chalet, in my little writing niche, because I like to write myself. And I've got a writing question tonight that Michelle has sent to me, and I was glad that she passed it along because I want to address it right now. The question is, Mr. Anderson, if you write a book about failure and it doesn't sell, is it called a success? Wow. This must have been one of my students because he or she is brilliant. I want to talk about that. Writing, first of all. I can talk about writing because I actually have done a little writing recently myself. From the Four Winds. My name right down there. And there's a picture, I think, that does me justice. It's quite handsome. Enough about that. I want to talk about writing. This question is a good question. If you write a book, that's a success. If it doesn't sell, that's a failure. That's an unusual mixture, isn't it? That's an oxymoron. Failure, success. I kind of look at it the way Mark Twain did it. If you write for 10 years and you don't sell anything, you should be chopping wood. Well, I would say, personally, talking about writing again, if you want to write well, keep writing. And if you get something out there, that's a success. Pat yourself on the back. I say you are a successful failure.
Coaches, Hall of Fame.
Oh, wow.
That was on March the 19th.
Downsize this.
Utah Coaches Hall of Fame.
These are your awards and things he's won throughout the years.
I have over 200.
Over 200, huh? I think that's quite impressive.
This is the greatest track team ever been in the state of Utah right there. We've had two Olympians at Millard High School.
Who are they?
Clarence Robinson, London, 5,000 meters, 1948. Richard George, javelin, Montreal, 1976.
Oh, dang, that's doggone cool.
This one here is Coach of the Year in 1969. This is when I ran at BYU. These are outstanding basketball and tennis trophies.
Holy cow. All right.
So long for the